And now I regret to say a certain amount of sex is creeping into this programme of my verse. I was recovering from an operation I thought was a very serious one. Of course it wasn't, but you know how one always thinks one's operation is very serious. On the edge of the Beaulieu River. The Beaulieu River is a tidal estuary, and it's a great place for people who potter about with small boats. And there's a sort of boat there called a sharpie, which is a small sailing boat. And I was in a dinghy rowing and had moored myself up, recovering from my operation among some reeds, when suddenly a sharpie passed with the most beautiful girl in it I think I've ever seen in my life. And she asked me the time, and rather than be at a loss, I made up what time it was so as to please her. And she smiled and thanked me, and it set my heart a-fluttering. And I wrote this poem about her. And I ought to say one further thing, that all along the Beaulieu River, here and there, there are little houses, or quite comfortable houses, situated on the banks, where people sit and have tea, or a drink of some sort, and look through opera glasses at the boats passing by, and quiz the rigging and the sailing and the way the boat is handled. And that accounts for a character called Mrs. Fairclough in this poem, who is sitting on the bank of the river and is an elderly lady watching this beautiful girl going by. Her name was Clemency Buckland, I subsequently discovered, and she was the daughter of a general. The title of the poem is Youth and Age on Beaulieu River, Hants. Early sun on Beaulieu water lights the undersides of oaks. Clumps of leaves it floods and blanches. All transparent glow the branches which the double sunlight soaks. To her craft on Beaulieu water, Clemency, the general's daughter, pulls across with even strokes. Schoolboy sure she is this morning, soon her sharpie's rigged and free. Cool beneath a garden awning, Mrs. Fairclough sipping tea, and raising large long-distance glasses as the little sharpie passes, sighs our sailor girl to see. Tulip figure so appealing, oval face so serious-eyed, tree roots past and muddy beaches, on to huge and lake-like reaches, soft and sun-warm see her glide, slacks the slim young limbs revealing, sun-brown arm the tiller feeling, with the wind and with the tide. Evening light will bring the water, day-long sun will burst the bud, Clemency, the general's daughter, will return upon the flood. But the older woman only knows the ebb tide leaves her lonely with the shining fields of mud.